Alright, man.
The greatest.
Y'all requested.
The greatest.
And Batman, once again, this is Old School Wednesdays. Old School Wednesdays, Old School Wednesdays, Old School Wednesdays.
There you go, nigga.
You dig what I'm saying?
Do the right guy, man.
So we gonna do this right here. That's the OG box.
She the best, nigga.
That's the OG box, though. This ain't retro. This that OG. This that OG right here.
Music is supposed to inspire. How come we ain't getting no higher? Now tell me your philosophy on exactly what an artist should be. Should they be someone with prosperity?
That what it look like right there.
So on the back of that all scratched up.
Yeah, it is all scratched up.
Damn thing.
Whatever. So yeah, man, we gonna do this Lauryn Hill, man.
Man, she the best, nigga. I told
and
you
this,
the
this
best.
This was back in the day, you know, they used to put lyrics up in the
nigga.
Book. You know what I mean?
Nothing even matters.
I ain't gonna show y'all the whole thing. Lauryn Hill, man, this album came out in 98, I think it was. Yeah, 1998. Rough House Records.
Yeah.
And I either got this album after or I got it with the Quemini album. Mm. And I just remember sitting down on my mom's couch, man, just, you know what I'm saying, put my headphones in and listen to this album, man. And like, going back and listen to this album, I listened to this album the other day. I was waiting in the doctor's office. They ain't called me back for about 2 hours. I got to listen to the whole Lauryn Hill album in the waiting area. And I was like, please don't call my name. I want to finish this album up. Mm-hmm. You dig what I'm saying? So the thing with this album, man, it's like this displays perfection. Yep. You can't get any better than this. And I think this is why a lot of people still basically are on her nuts.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
This is why I'm on her nuts still too.
This is perfection, man. I mean, yep. You can't get any better than this, man. It's like, it honestly feels like you've been cheated because she hasn't put anything else out besides, you know, after this, except for the Unplugged.
The MTV thing.
Yeah, MTV Live, you know what I'm saying? And just listen to this album, I mean, from every single track, even just the intro, you know, her interludes and her skits on there, basically, you know, the album starts off with them in the classroom.
She misses roll call.
You know, she misses roll call.
Let's go.
You know, and then it goes into Lost Ones, man. I mean,
it's funny how money changes situation. Miscommunication lead to complication. My emancipation don't fit your equation. I was on the humble, you on every station. Someone play young Lauryn like she done. But remember not to game the one of the sun. Everything you did has already been done. I know all the tricks from bricks to Kingston. My ting done major kingdom one wrong. To understand El Boogie, not violent.
My little story about this, man, the first time I heard this particular album, man, and the first song I did hear was The Lost Ones, I was in my mom's car, chilling, cruising in the back seat, and as soon as I heard that, nigga, that's the first time I stole something from my mama. I stole this album. And you know what I told her when she was looking for it? You know, you'd be like, nigga, where am I at? I don't know. In my room, under my pillow, nigga. With my headphones, going to sleep, listening to this album day and night, nigga. Where my shit at? Where y'all see my...
The one thing, and this is another reason why, you know, we do Old School Wednesdays, man, is to educate and, you know, teach and to learn you.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying?
The miseducation of y'all.
And the thing about it too, man, is like albums like these, mm-hmm. like you don't drop an album every year. You don't drop an album every 2 years. Like this album here flourished from 1998 all the way to like 2001.
Yeah.
Basically. You know what I'm saying?
See, in my life, nigga, until now, I can listen to this shit.
No, but I'm just talking about just how they extended this album.
I understand.
Like, the singles, all of that. You know what I'm saying? Like
the videos.
The videos, all that stuff, man. I mean,
That thing,
watch out, some girls only about that thing.
The second verse is dedicated to the man. More concerned with his rims and his Timbs and his women. Him and his man come in the club like hooligans. Don't care who they offend, Papa Yang.
Like you got yin.
Let's not pretend. The one that pack pissed out by the waist, man. Crissed out by the casement. Still the name of this basement. The pretty face man claiming that they did a bid, man. Need to take care of their 3 and 4 kids. Been the face in court case when the child support's late. Money taking, heartbreaking. Now you wonder why women hate me. The sneaky silent man. The punk domestic violence man. The quick to shoot the semen. Stop at.
And now that's the doo-wop joint. But every, I'm talking about, man, every single track on here, man. Every single track.
Can you name my favorite
X-Factor
track?
No. Like one of my favorite tracks is, man. When It Hurts So Bad.
Nigga.
Zion.
Nigga.
I mean.
Nigga.
Nothing Even Matters.
Nothing Even Matters, like, nigga, with D'Angelo.
That's what I'm saying, like. All of, like, and the thing too, man, it's like with Lauryn Hill, she also was a vocalist.
Yes.
Like, the very first time, me personally, that I discovered Lauryn Hill was Sister Act 2.
Let's go.
You know what I'm saying? I think it was like 94, 95, like, or something like that.
Damn,
94.
Say,
yeah, it was a lot of talented people in that movie too, yeah, man. But I was a JIT, you know what I'm saying? And,
Old Boy, that was in that one group that.
Yeah, City High.
City High.
Old Boy from City High was in there.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, man, that's the first time I actually discovered Lauryn Hill, because Lauryn Hill reminded me of my cousin, man.
Dang.
She looked just like my cousin, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, then from there was the doggone the Fugees, you know what I'm saying? They first LP, and then it was really the second LP that, you know, we already did the Old School Wednesdays on that to score. And then, you know, basically they just, you know, flourished onto their, you know, to their single LPs. And, I mean, honestly, man, she had the best one. I mean, it's without a question, but on the scores where she really displayed her full, you know, fledged, you know, just beginning, she's an MC, she can spit, like she spit fire,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying, spit nothing but fire, you know what I mean, and then the girl can sing. This album right here, man, is just amazing. I don't know anybody that don't love this album.
Love,
you know what I'm saying?
Not like love.
Love this album. I'm talking about from cats, you know what I mean? From age 0 to 60.
Yeah, man.
You know what I mean? Like maybe even 80. You dig what I'm saying? Like this album right here, man, was just, it was perfect,
incredible,
man.
Incredible, man. The song to me, like, it's a couple of songs I hear that makes it, that when I hear it, man, I can't listen to it in certain situations. I can't listen to the song that she did for the movie. It's like a bonus track on here. Too Good to Be True.
Yeah.
She did for the movie Conspiracy Theory.
Yeah.
I can't listen to that song when I'm around my niggas, cause I get emotional. I remember I heard the song, and that song stuck with me, because that's when I first kind of realized that I loved my wife when she was my girlfriend. So when I heard this song, I'm like, fuck, I need the words of the song. I need you, baby. Quite alright. I need you, baby. To a woman of lonely nights. I was like, let me love you. Everything be okay. So I'm like, damn, like that's when it hit me. I love this woman. And like when I hear that song, I just look at, I just stare at her ass like,
you don't even know.
But when I hear that song, man, like that's the kind of shit that music used to do to a nigga back in the day, man. What solidified to me that she was one of the best lyricists, and I'm gonna stick with what my brother said, the best MC, rank and what top the rank MCs in that little, not even girl, but MC period, is The Final Hour. Well, I'ma get the mozzarella, the acapella, that shit right there, cause
down the ground beat like Palestine. Say your rhyme, let's see if they get you out your mind. Now I'ma get the mozzarella like a Rockefeller. Still be in the church of Lalabella, singing hymns, acapella, whether posed in Marabella and Couture, or collecting residuals from off the score. I'm making sure I'm with the 144. I been here before, this ain't a battle, this is war. Word to Boonie, I make a lot like a Sunni. Your diplomatic community and every ghetto community had opportunity. Went from hood shock to hood sheep, but it ain't what you cop, it's about what you keep.
When I heard that motherfucking song there, that she just flowing, I was like, nobody can touch me. I said, bitch.
Man.
I can't curse because there's some babies out here, Nick. But I'm going to tell you, when I heard that, that little flow she did, I was like, well, you can get the money. You can get the power. Keep your eyes on the final hour. You can get the money. You can get the power. On the final hour. I mean, listen, man. I'm gonna tell you. I want to crank up. I wish it was in your apartment. I feel like Dragonfly Joe. I feel like Dragonfly Joe, and he'd be like, listen, dog. Like, I'm cranking up, dog. Like, the spirit is still like,
yeah, man.
Blowing. I mean, somebody ate y'all.
But you know what, though?
Let's break out of jail right now.
No. This is what music used to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, it don't have an impact no more, man.
I don't feel it.
I don't feel it like that.
Nothing.
More,
I don't.
Like,
have
honestly, it. I try. Like,
that's why we listen to the album 7 times in a row.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, I shouldn't have to listen to the album 10 times, 11, 12. That's as a 9.
That's a 10. That's a 11.
You dig what I'm saying? So, you know, this album, man, like, if y'all don't have it, please go buy it.
Oh, you
go download it.
No,
you know
fuck
what I'm
that,
saying?
Nigga. Do the shit, nigga. The contest, nigga.
No, we gon' it's okay, man. This is what we gon' do.
This is what we gon' goddamn do.
I just love this. I love the CD so much, man. When, you know, you like, you comment, you subscribe, and just comment on this video right here. This Old School Wednesdays, man. This is something special we gonna do because we bring Old School Wednesdays back, man.
Yeah, man.
We are gonna give away a free copy of this CD right here. You know what I'm saying? So y'all like, y'all comment, y'all subscribe, but comment on this. You know what I mean? Video right here, and we're gonna give away Lauryn Hill's Miseducation of Lauryn Hill.
Well, if you can, please do the unboxing of it when you get it, and do a video response for this video.
And do a video response
of you doing the unboxing.
Also, send a picture to give it a grade TV at gmail.com.
Yeah.
Also, on Twitter. At give it a grade TV.
Yeah.
Huff at InUnison85.
Yeah.
Block at Mr. Rain LLC.
Yes.
And if you have Instagram as well,
yes.
At Huff, give it a grade TV on Instagram. At Block Your Bish on Instagram as well.
Oh,
so if y'all, you know, if whoever wins and stuff like that, you know, make sure that y'all, you know, take a picture, you know, unbox it and everything, send a video response, and, you know, send a picture on Twitter and everything, man. We're going to retweet y'all,
Yeah. Shout
y'all out and everything,
yeah,
man. So, when this video's up, we're going to give it about, I say we'll do 2 weeks, you know what I'm saying, and then we'll announce the winner
Yeah. Of
this Old School Wednesdays contest right here, man. So, say, man, we're going to have a lot of different stuff going on, man, because albums that we love so much, we're going to give them away. You know what I'm saying? So, certain albums that we love so much, we're just gonna be like, you know what, man? We're gonna give away a free copy of it. Just so y'all boys know, and y'all ladies and y'all gentlemen out there know, man, Yeah. How much we really love and how much we really dedicated
ladies
to this hip hop, man. You know what I mean? So, I mean, just every single track here, man, Lost Ones, X Factors, To Zion, Doo Wop, Superstar, Final Hour, When It Hurts So Bad, I Used to Love Them, Father Forgive Them, Every Ghetto, Every City, Nothing Even Matters, Everything Is Everything, The Miseducation, I mean, like, just the
combo,
feel, man. Just the feel, man, I mean,
crazy, it's
the
it's,
feel is ridiculous, man, I mean, every she displayed her passion, everything on here, man, everything, man, I just,
it's indescribable, man.
It just brought me back, man. It brought me back. Thank you, Miss Lauryn Hill, for everything that you have done and displayed and just presented to us in hip hop, man. And, you know, I will always support you, even though, you know, I haven't heard from you in so long, man. And, you know, hopefully, you know, I think she only got jail for like 3 months or something like that. Which she shouldn't have got it anyway. Boy, that's neither here nor there, Zimmerman, bitch ass nigga. Anyways, so yeah, man, Old School Wednesdays, we're bringing it back, man. Y'all like, comment, subscribe, share, you know what I mean? And it's back for y'all boys, man, for real, man. That's how we doing it right there, man. Give it a great TV. You bitch, you. Shout out to Nemo Hoes.